This is Mike Regan, GamingRing.com, with the Paragon of Knowledge, Matt Stryker.
Very good. The most hated man in wrestling, but I like the Paragon of Knowledge. It's very good. Either way, I'm still cool.
Now, you manage Big Daddy V.
Yes, I do.
Now, he's not going to be in the Battle Royal, the 24-man Battle Royal. As a manager, don't you think you're going to do your job to get him in the Battle Royal?
Let me stop you right there. Okay. Last year's WrestleMania, I was a competitor, and a damn good competitor. This year's WrestleMania, I will take Big Daddy V's place in the Battle Royal. There's something called bigger and better, and that's not just me.
Hi.
Big Daddy V and I have a plan. So I will be in the Battle Royal. I will win the Battle Royal. I'll go on to face Chavo Guerrero. Once I win the ECW title, I will hand it over to Big Daddy V. Of course, we'll get an extension so we can go around his back and belly. And we will move on together and just pretty much dominate all the WWE.
Now, but here's the thing, though. Big Daddy V is like the most dominating superstar in WWE history. I mean, he's been dominating ECW for months.
Right.
And you haven't.
Do I have what?
You haven't. You have not dominated.
I have not dominated.
No, you've been a manager.
How do you define domination?
Basically beating up anybody who faces them.
Okay, I don't need to physically beat anyone up. I have a 186 IQ, and that's the truth. I have a master's degree in educational psychology. I'm beating you right now as we speak. So that's where my power comes into play. So don't you worry about Big Daddy V. Worry about me.
Now, tonight we're at the Superstar Challenge.
It took you a while to get to that.
Yes, it did. But I wanted to ask about the Big Daddy V. I'm a big Big Daddy Mark,
cool.
You know.
Okay.
Anyway, we're at the Superstar Challenge, and you're going to be in the tournament.
So you didn't do your homework. I'm hosting the tournament.
Oh, I thought you were competing.
No, hi. Welcome to the show. I'm Matt. It's nice to see you. I hosted last year, did extremely well, hosting again this year. I'm the most hated man in wrestling, but I'm also the most personable man in wrestling. And honestly, all kidding aside, I am looking forward to this. It's a lot of fun. We get to interact with the fans, get to talk to schlubs like you. And we just basically get to see the advancements in the game from year to year, which is pretty exciting to me.
Are you a big video game fan?
Actually, I really, really am. Especially through college, I really enjoyed playing games like Madden and NHL and things like that. I would, you know, some of my friends would use some herbal enhancements to become better in the video game. I, of course, don't condone that. I say drink milk, eat Nilla wafers. But, I really do, and I think that the way technology's going, gaming's only going to get better.
Now, have you, as a teacher in the New York School District, have you ever had to take, a Game Boy or a PSP away from your students?
Oh, well, my collection of PSPs, Game Boys, and Nintendo DS is actually DS with the apostrophe after the S because it takes possession of the S. That actually comes from confiscating it from my students. Why buy?
So you say Madden's your favorite game?
I'm sorry?
So you said Madden's your favorite game?
No, I like NHL, all the NHL EA Sports games, but all time, my two favorite games are Baseball Stars for Nintendo and the old RBI Baseball. And I was just talking to somebody that if I would play RBI Baseball in the morning and go to school, I wouldn't have to press pause. I could just leave the game alone, and the figures would just go doom, doom, doo, doom, 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 and then I'd come back home from school and continue playing my game.
Have you ever played Baseball Simulator 2000?
No, I have not.
That's a good game.
At least I'm honest.
Yes.
Right? I could have been like, totally. Hey.
Yeah, I love that game. Now, WrestleMania, what do you think match has the potential to steal the show?
You know, a lot of people are asking which match is going to stand out. And really, you can pick any match you want that's really going to steal the show. I got to go with the World's Heavyweight Championship match between Edge and The Undertaker. Because if anyone can stop The Undertaker's streak, it's Edge. But the thing with The Undertaker is, everywhere we go across the world, fans love him. And unless you're there at a live event, that energy really, really feeds a competitor. So as a fan, which I am before anything, that's the match I'm really looking forward to, is Edge versus The Undertaker. Number two on my list, Money in the Bank ladder match, because there's just going to be carnage everywhere, and I like that.
A train wreck.
Absolutely. Kind of like your haircut.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Now, who is your favorite? You said you're a fan. Who is your favorite all-time WWE superstar besides yourself?
Sure. All-time, I have to go with the man that you love to hate, and I've gone on to become the most hated man in wrestling, Rowdy Roddy Piper. There was something about him, he just raised your emotions. He riled you up, and that's something that I like to think that I have the ability to do, and a lot of that comes from being a fan of Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Have you ever talked to him and asked for hints? I mean, what about your persona,
well,
your character?
Again, I'm glad that you watched the product, because on June 26th last year, my birthday, Rowdy Roddy Piper sung happy birthday to me, or sang, if you really want to get bogged down in semantics, in San Antonio, and then he proceeded to put a cake in my face. Then the boogeyman came along and made me eat worms. But I'm going to tell you something, all that aside, it was still the best birthday present I could have ever had, because I shared the ring and the microphone with an absolute legend in this business, Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Matt, good luck tonight. Good luck at WrestleMania. Thank you. Have a good day.